Hey guys, welcome to Indie Style and Happy Holidays. I am your host, Leah DeVon. We have a beautiful artistic show planned for you today. You are going to meet award-winning photographer Gay Allen, learn some really fun facts about her. We're going to have an opportunity to view her lovely space and see her work. Stay tuned. You're not going to want to miss a thing. We'll be right back. Here on Indie Style, we'll feature successful entrepreneurs from across the globe who are making incredible strides in their industry. You may not know their names yet, but you soon will. I'm Leah DeVon, and this is Indie Style. Hey guys, welcome back to Indie Style, and if you are just tuning in, I am sitting here with award-winning photographer Gay Allen. Welcome
thank
to
you.
Indie Style, and thank you for inviting us to view your work in your beautiful home. Her space is exquisite. I cannot wait for you to show us, but of course I want to talk a little bit about Gay Allen, the photographer. You are an award-winning photographer.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit of background about your history with photography.
Well, I got a camera when I was 5 years old from my mom, and I used it like anybody uses a camera, just to take family shots. But I knew I was about 10 years ago, I knew I was going to be planning for retirement. So I thought, well, I want to do something that's exciting and interesting and takes advantage of my computer skills as well as my artistic background and my photography. So I put the two together and do digital alteration of photographs.
Okay.
And it's sort of like, I tell this thing about it's sort of like you get the big excitement about taking the photograph, but then you get the excitement about seeing it post-production and being able to manipulate it. You get the excitement of being in the gallery and having people talk to you about it and selling it.
Right.
It's just like it keeps on giving.
And it's so beautiful, you guys. I had the privilege of running into Gay a couple weeks ago at a gallery that is here in Buckhead, Georgia, and I was blown away. I was just kind of like a five-year-old. I was like, oh my gosh, your work is so beautiful. I mean, I've seen photography, but what you do to your photography is just absolutely, it's just breathtaking. And it's so, remember, I kept going, okay, wait, is this a photo? You kept going, yes, Lee, it's a photograph. So can we take a walk through your space and see your work, and can you kind of tell us a little bit about it?
Certainly.
Okay, but guys, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Not getting enough Indie Style? Watch full episodes at indiestyletv.com and be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube to find out who is doing it Indie Style.
And welcome back to Indie Style. And guys, we're here with Gay Allen. She is an award-winning photographer. And we have the opportunity to walk through her beautiful home and see some of her work. And you are a digital photographer, the best that I've ever seen. Tell us a little bit about the process and about this beautiful picture that we're looking at right now. Because I keep going, it's a picture, right? This is a photo. It looks like you painted it.
Well,
I keep saying like, painting.
That's a very good observation, because there's a word or a phrase called painterly refacimento. It's Italian.
Can you say that, guys? I can't.
And what it means is that you alter things with computer. You can use any means to do it, or any pieces of software. But I brought this one first so that you would, this is three girls, as you know, in bikinis, and you could just take that and you could make it a very good photograph. But there are several things that I do, is I say, well, what is the beautiful story here? They each have long, gorgeous hair. They each, you know, and their shapes were all right. They were nice shapely girls. But their hair in the sunshine was just magnificent.
Wow.
We had a brunette and a redhead and a blonde.
Perfect, right?
And so I thought that was perfect. Colorful bikinis.
Right.
So I turned them around backwards. Now, that in itself would have made a good photograph. But I wanted the painterly aspects of what I saw. And so using the computer, I was able to take the pixels, the actual little pixels,
right,
and rearrange them so that it does look like a painting or an imaginary scene of some kind.
That's absolutely beautiful.
And that is taking reality to an abstraction that is artistic.
Right, right.
And we'll see some things later where you see nature do that, but this is where you do this digitally. So some of the things we'll see, you'll have that question about, well, why did she do this or why did she do this? I do this because I believe in today's world we have so much distraction and we have so much chaos,
right,
that we ought to be able to make that chaos beautiful.
Right,
so some
right.
of my things are chaotic, but I still try to retain the beauty.
Well, this is absolutely beautiful. And there's still mystery, of course. I'm like, what did their faces look like? But it's absolutely beautiful. And just the artistic quality is exceptional. And I'm going to say that just because everything that I've seen so far, every time I see it, I have a lot of questions. Like, how did she do that? What did she use to do that? Can we continue on to
sure.
see some more of your work?
Let's go.
Okay. I'm going to be careful.
Just down.
Okay.
So in buying this house, I liked it because it had wide open spaces, and I have my gallery here.
Which is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
And the reason that you put the shelving up, or I put the shelving up, is if when I'm planning a show, I can line up things and see how they go together.
Okay.
And that allows me to see if the sizes are correct or the colors are right. And what you have here is some larger things that I've done up there. This was a first place at Atlanta Artist Center 1 year. That's a boat in a marsh, and it was moving.
Oh, wow.
And so I took the camera and moved with it.
Okay.
And that's how I got that very nice boat in the marsh.
Okay.
But the rest of these are manipulated. And if you just want to sort of start down here.
Right here?
That is how I manipulate in the camera. I'm out in the lawn. I'm jumping around at Christmas time with Christmas lights. It's midnight or 4 a.m., whatever. And I'm jumping around. I'm doing cartwheels. I'm doing all kinds of crazy
I
things.
I want to see you when we do that. We're going to jump and do cartwheels.
I'm telling you, it's a wonder I haven't been arrested, you know. People look out and see me on their lawn and wonder, what's that crazy thing?
Oh, that's awesome.
But in order to catch the movement, the activity.
Okay.
But when I actually saw it in the camera, it looks like birds flying through an upside-down St. Louis arch.
Oh, wow.
Almost.
Okay.
So I just let my imagination go wild after that.
Right. Okay.
Next one is bug tracks on a condenser outside of a greenhouse. And see how beautiful the bug's excrement is. I mean, that's the bug's poop.
It doesn't look like bug's poop. That's so beautiful. It looks like gold, and it just looks like a very rich picture.
It is.
It's very, very abstract, as you say, for what you've created. And, of course, you know, I'm really excited because I had a chance to see this picture, or this, can I say picture or photograph? At one of the showings, one of the galleries that I met Gay at. Tell us a little bit about this one.
Well, we had two models, and you'll see both of them before we're finished, but this young woman was just amazing. She had this gorgeous hair that just went for yards and yards and yards, and I told her, get it out of your, she had it all tied up, and said, no, I want to see that. So she took it all out, and then we played with some masks and some scarves and things. And she was just so emotive that I wanted to capture that. And then bringing it back again to highlighting this mask and this face and pulling that out, making it very dramatic to further enhance her attitude. You know, that's her attitude.
Right.
And so
and she took her hair down for you.
Oh, yes.
You know how we are with our hair ladies, right? So she really loved you. That is just such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful picture. Tell us about this one.
Well, this is actually lichens on a tree, and these little cells are little colonies that the lichens build, and I didn't manipulate it into a circle. That's the way they build them. That part is not manipulated. The only thing I did was just make them a little more dramatic.
Oh.
That's what that little animal does.
Okay.
And I just was captivated. It's only about this big.
Okay.
You know, like 3 inches across.
Wow.
But I just fell in love with that. And then this was just the tree running down the middle of it.
Beautiful. Okay, so I have to stop and tell you guys a really fun fact about Gabe, but you have to stay tuned. You're going to go, really, when I tell you the fun fact? Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
On Indie Style, we'll feature successful entrepreneurs from across the globe who are making incredible strides in their industry. You may not know their names yet, but you soon will. I'm Leah DeVon, and this is indie style.
Hey guys, welcome back to Indie Style, and we are here hanging out with the incredibly talented and award-winning photographer, Gay Allen. We are in her beautiful home, in her space, her own personal gallery, and we're kind of walking around and she's showing us some of her beautiful work. So tell us a little bit about fused glass.
One of the things I wanted to do was, I do fused glass work where I build these panels, but I wanted to combine my interest in photography and the fused glass. So what these two are is behind is a photograph, and I build the glass around
it. I'm so nervous. I'm like cupping it like a baby. Say it one more time.
There's a photograph behind.
Okay.
And that's what this is like. This is a photograph of a Ferris wheel.
Okay.
And so then I build the fused glass over it. And that this is all the carnival things that you see here.
Mm-hmm.
So I built a carnival around in fused glass around the photograph of a Ferris wheel. And then you don't fire the photograph, obviously, but because the fused glass has to fire to 1,400 degrees. So you take the photograph away.
How do you do that? You have like those goggles on and the glass or the fire.
You have a kiln. You do it in a kiln.
Really?
Yeah. And I don't have one. I use a lab. But that's how it looks raised, but molten.
Right.
You take it out at a certain time and it doesn't go flat. That one's more flat than this one would be. But so I've been able to combine my photography with my fused glass work as well. I think that as humans, we ought to grow. And the way to grow is to step out of your comfort zone and try new things.
That might be like a New Year's resolution. Because we're always very uncomfortable to do something that we know we may not succeed at. But look at you giving advice.
Okay.
But this is beautiful, beautiful. And I want to tell everybody a fun fact about Gay. She's so multi-talented. Do you want me to tell them or do you want to tell them?
Go ahead.
Okay, you guys, she was one of the first, watch me get it wrong, one of the first female anchors on ABC News.
It wasn't on a specific national network.
Right.
I worked for Corinthian Broadcasting out of New York. They hired six of us to go to various markets.
Right.
We were the first female news anchors in the United States.
I love that.
Yeah.
Okay. And you did it for?
I did for a couple of years, and I actually burned out.
She was like, yep, I was one of the first, but see you later. That's so neat, though.
Sorry.
Cool. Very fun fact. Okay, so where are we moving to?
Okay.
Well, but wait, guys, stay tuned. We'll be back. We're going to take a little break.
Are you still doing it indie style? To be a guest on our show, visit our website today at indiestyletv.com.
And we are back with Gay Allen, and we are in her beautiful creative space today. Learning about all of her wonderful photography. And tell us about this beautiful work over here, Gay.
Okay. One of the things about nature and the things we photograph is that sometimes we fail to realize or recognize the geometry of things. So I decided I was going to do a whole series of geometric alterations. Here, this is water falling over a waterfall.
Oh, wow.
And yet you've got...
Okay, I see that.
This is a tree and its bark, and there you've got three worlds that just show the geometry of beauty in just this texture that you find on a tree. This, obviously, is of some weeds where I've just made it into a whole globe. Now, that is being done by other people now, and there's actually an app out that you can do that with, but I had to sort of manipulate that myself in order to get there. And this, all I did was just... take the same photograph and arrange four copies of it on a page. But it shows geometry and how a sunrise can actually be magnified and beautiful by doing it four times. There again, that is a fountain. It's a building here in Atlanta. And it was a beautiful mounded fountain. And when you photographed it as a mound, it was boring because all the water coming around it was just... water, 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 water.
Right, right, right.
And there was a building behind it that had these wonderful blue reflections, and I wanted to bring that in. So I globalized, altered it in order to make it a globe, and then took out everything except just the water fountain and the blue on the building.
Wow.
And there's your geometry.
Are you guys paying attention? I got B's in geometry, but I tell you, this is like fantastic. Okay, and then sunrise, sunset.
Well, this is the sunset over the marsh.
Got that one right.
And there again, it was across the marsh, and I wanted to show the depth of what I went through in order just to take that photograph, and the what the reeds were doing with the light. And so I extended it and created a perspective that is leading out into the, you know, the distance.
Amazing, amazing. Okay, so how many pieces of artwork have you created, do you think, about?
I almost don't want to tell you because people don't believe it.
But I want you to tell me.
I've worked on 16,000 things.
Whoa. I believe it. I actually believe it.
I can prove it. So
I believe it.
You know.
Wow. And where could we find you? What's your website?
My website is www.hgayallen.com.
So if we go to your website, we'll know where you are showing your work.
I'm showing here in Atlanta. I've actually shown, however, in D.C., Denver, the West Coast, New York, various places.
I'm not surprised. Your work is just stunning. I'm so glad that we had a chance to meet you. You are just the epitome of an incredible, successful entrepreneur.
Thank you
so much for your time. And I know only continued success is going to come your way.
Thank you.
So, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. We'll be right back.
You're watching Indie Style with Leah DeVon. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, I'm Leah DeVon, host of Indie Style TV. From our team to yours, we want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas and a joyous New Year.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.